Well, what I'm working on here is the investigation of the symbolic representation of power in the 19th century. And I'm taking as my examples the new emperors who were created or who created themselves in that century. So, of course, I start off with Napoleon I and I have Napoleon III. I have the new emperors of Austria. I have the German emperors from 1871. I have two Mexican emperors, two Brazilian emperors, and then the grand crescendo, Queen Victoria, Empress of India. Now, anybody who is in Paris is walking around in an imperial city. There is architecture, which is the product of this projection of symbolic power. There are wonderful paintings. If you go to the Louvre or you go to the History Museum at the Chateau de Versailles, you see the representation, the symbolic representation of power. And similarly, you can do the same if you go to Rio de Janeiro, you go to Berlin, or you look at what happened in India. So I'm investigating this in a very interesting century. When you have the development of the middle classes, you have a huge explosion of different kinds of media, all the way up to photography and film. So I have a huge amount of material to examine, and I'm hoping that I'll be able to draw some sort of conclusions about how power is represented even today, because we see some of the same techniques with our modern rulers.